So far, we've only looked at stellations of platonic solids, but in fact any polyhedron can be stellated. This final video in the stellation series is a quick glance at some of the other possibilities. Prisms are simple polyhedra that can be stellated to form star prisms, like this pentagonal prism morphing into a pentagrammic prism, or this octagonal prism morphing into two intersecting square prisms. Antiprisms permit more possibilities, such as extending their triangular faces until they meet at a point to form a trapezohedron, though it's doubtful that these are true stellations, as the original two end faces have disappeared completely. Catalan solids are a rich source of interesting stellations. The rhombic dodecahedron is one of the simpler examples. The faces are not regular, they're diamond-shaped, so the stellation diagram has an intriguing asymmetry, reflecting the face shape. The cells fall into four layers, forming four main stellations, including the original. But the outer layer isn't a complete cover, so there's one more hollow stellation consisting of just this outer layer without the supporting inner layers. Archimedean solids are more complicated because they have more than one face type. This means there is more than one stellation diagram. The cuboctahedron, for example, has this diagram for the triangular faces and this for the square faces. There are a huge number of cells of 8 different types, which make 21 different stellations. The final stellation is this strange figure, a complex shape that nevertheless still possesses a certain cuboctahedronness, an echo of its origin. The possibilities are endless. That's where this series ends, but really it's only the beginning of the journey. As always, thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.